Ooh, it's starting. Oh, rated M. I'm rated M game. Interesting.
Hi everyone, welcome to Nintendo Direct. I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi from Nintendo.
Okay. I'll be your guide. Yeah, I gotcha. How long is this going
to
be?
Nintendo Direct will continue to deliver information on a variety of products, including Nintendo Switch.
Switch?
Today, we'll take a deeper dive into ARMS and Splatoon 2. But first, let's start with Nintendo 3DS.
Okay, we're starting with the DS, or the 3DS.
All right, time to speed run
the
through
the SS Doll. Oh, okay, we're starting with the Pikmin game. It's called
Captain
Hey
Olimar
Pikmin. Okay. That's interesting name. Interesting name.
Will give you a new perspective.
This just reminds me of the Chibi Robo game, I'm not going to lie, which I guess isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it's like those licensed games you would get for GBA. They're not bad, but they're like so short even if they're good. Or they're just average. But I don't know, this one does seem a bit more interesting than Chibi Robo. That was a short trailer. July 28th? Okay.
That same day,
oh, a Pikmin amiibo. Okay, I like that one actually.
In the run-up to launch, we'll reveal more about amiibo functionality.
Okay,
and what's
sure.
In store for Olimar
sure.
And his Pikmin.
All right, Ever Oasis. That's a pretty
Hello.
Cool
I'm
plush, I guess.
Producer and director of Ever Oasis from Grezzo.
It seems like they're going to be going through the 3DS stuff pretty quickly, which Oasis, could mean something decently big. I doubt it, but you never know.
To help it grow and thrive. ESNA is an important partner who will nourish the Oasis with water and support your adventures. As you overcome the many challenges that face the Oasis, I hope you'll recognize the bond that links your heart and life with those of ESNA. The story has been designed to illustrate the importance of kindness and at times to touch the heart.
All right, once again, that went pretty quick. June 23rd, though. Okay, I might pick it up. I don't know. Looks all right.
You more about the bittersweet world of Ever Oasis, so be on the lookout for more information.
Yeah, they're going through the 3DS stuff pretty quickly. Monster Hunter. Oh, finally, Monster Hunter Stories for the West? Finally, I've been waiting for this.
Monster Hunter series has ever known. In Monster Hunter Stories, become a rider and bond with monsters to raise their potential and unleash powerful combos. Players can fly, swim, and crash into new areas of the map, discover eggs to collect and hatch, and participate in turn-based battles with a party of multiple monsters. Monster Hunter Stories launches on Nintendo.
Okay, when's it coming out? Okay, this fall, I'm assuming for the West. Are we going to get the amiibo, though? What is this? Oh, Yo-Kai Watch, okay.
We all know why.
Yeah, I don't know, I've never really tried Yo-Kai Watch. I mean, it looks alright, but I don't know.
In love with it again. The definitive version of the sequel is here. Yo-Kai Watch 2, Psychic Spectres. You don't need to be a mind reader to know that the new exclusive quest will be wild. From the ability to befriend wicked Yo-Kai, to the origin of Darkneon. You'll even hop a ride on the Hexpress to a new resort area. Plus, the fan-favorite multiplayer action mode has been expanded into Psychic Yo-Kai Watch Blasters, which lets you team up with friends to battle new challenging bosses. Once again, the time has come to get inspirited by the world of Yo-Kai in fall of 2017.
All right. I mean, it looked all right.
NIS America.
Ooh, something with Kirby.
Some of their best to the
at
West.
The bottom.
The Cold Step series is
I don't really know much about this
20th
series.
Anniversary. And
but,
what better way than with the release of Cold Step Revolt on Nintendo 3DS?
I don't know. Seems alright, I guess.
Endless strategy in the newest entry of this popular card meets board game mashup. It's releasing August 29th.
Yeah, they're going through all this pretty quickly.
Edition.
I mean, I don't know how long the direct is, but.
Infinite amount of
tail okay, I just wanted to try RPG Maker.
RPG Maker Fest. This RPG creation tool will allow you to share your stories online with other players when it launches on Nintendo 3DS. Downloadable content will include crossover character skins from Disgaea, Disgaea 5, and more. You can share the greatness of Prinny with your friends.
Okay.
A free download called Maker Player will also be available in Nintendo
eShop. It'd be really cool if they just signed like this for Zelda, to be
RPGs
honest.
You make
or even Fire
RPG
Emblem.
Maker Fest.
Whether they own, I mean, obviously this isn't made by Nintendo, but, you know. You can wield
the full power of this incredible tool by purchasing the standard or limited edition when they launch in the U.S. June 27th.
What is Miitopia? Oh, okay. Have you ever played an RPG
like this before? In Miitopia, the Dark Lord has stolen the townspeople's faces, and only you can restore them. Cast new characters of your friends and your favorite people in.
Oh, apparently the new Zelda amiibos have been announced. Wow, they look. Really? Really? They chose the Goron mask for Majora's Mask? Weird. Very weird.
Together you'll battle enemies, hunt treasure, and open up new areas of the map. The turn-based battles are straight out of a JRPG, except with a twist. Your allies have a mind of their own. The relationships you build affect their performance in battle.
Wait, is this like a whole separate game or what?
Learn new abilities. And with a high friendship status, they may even team up for attacks. Defeat an enemy and you'll earn XP, which can be used to unlock more abilities. Imagine casting one of your best friends as a gritty warrior, or seeing your boss as a pop star. In Miitopia, you'll have that power. And many, many more.
When
the game launches later this year.
Also, it is like a cartridge game? Fire Emblem Echoes updates, okay.
Shadows of Valentia will take the series back to its roots.
We're gonna hear about that corn amiibo?
One modern enhancement will expand your adventure.
I actually am really looking forward to this game.
Some of it will be free.
Some
will be paid. But no matter what, you can expect new maps.
I never really did the DLC for most of the 3DS Fire Emblem games. While earning you more, never really seen that appealing except for Revelation for Fates. I forget the name of it.
This content can be purchased individually, in packs, or all at once through a season pass. So you can
season pass.
Keep your eyes on the horizon for full details,
yeah, whatever.
Including release timing.
Not that big a deal. Ooh, Kirby, let's see, let's see.
25th anniversary. In celebration, we've prepared a few fun little surprises.
Like?
First, the Team Kirby Clash Deluxe game is headed to Nintendo eShop on Nintendo 3DS.
Okay.
And this co-op action game, Kirby.
There has to be a Kirby amiibo. Do battle with giant enemies. Or another set of Kirby amiibos.
Town and form
maybe?
A team from four roles. Sword Hero, Hammer Lord, Beam Mage, or Dr. Heelmore. Go it alone or together with friends. There are tons
of quests.
I
mean, whatever.
There's a brand new challenge system. Team Kirby Clash Deluxe is a free to start game, and you can get started
free
right
to
away
start.
When it launches today. Next, Kirby's Blowout Blast is also headed to Nintendo 3DS systems.
Blowout Blast?
Kirby is about to fight his way through a series of challenges.
Was this in the last Kirby game, like as a mini game or what?
Stages. The more enemies you inhale, the more firepower you wield. The stages are bigger than in Kirby 3D Rumble, and the challenge is too. Wipe out entire troops of enemies all at once, and go for a bronze, silver, or gold star when the game becomes available.
Since one is Meta, not Meta, since one is King Dedede an enemy, come on.
And last but not least, a new multiplayer action game is in development for Nintendo 3DS systems.
Okay, wait, for 3DS?
In stores and on Nintendo eShop okay, this
whatever.
Holiday. So you could say that 2017 is Kirby's big year.
Well, I don't know if I'd say... Bye-bye, box boy.
In an odd twist of fate, a box is the last defense against annihilation.
Box boy.
Luckily, Kirby is no ordinary box.
Box
adorable
boy. We barely knew you.
Q-babies lend him four new powers in the final game of the Box Boy trilogy. Create boxes to climb, hover, warp, and bomb your way to salvation. Do whatever it takes to solve more than 100 puzzles.
Oh, apparently the Smash amiibos were announced.
And destroy
Cloud
the
looks really good.
Once and for all.
Oh, they have two versions. My wallet. My wallet.
And dress for success with amiibo costumes. If you have save data of the first two games, you can play this one with the Game Boy or monochromatic filter on. Try a demo for all three games today. And check out boxboy.nintendo.com for more info. Or better yet, just purchase and download the latest installment in the series. Created by HAL Laboratory, the developers behind the Kirby series.
Yeah.
Boxboy launches today.
Oh, it's out today.
Shop for Nintendo
okay,
3DS.
Okay. My wallet's hurting even more. Can you figure out the
three new
Legend of Zelda, yeah.
Link from past
yeah, I don't know why they went with the Goron mask. I don't really like the Skyward Sword one.
Amiibo figures for Cloud, Corrin, and Bayonetta.
They look so good.
To stores on July 21st.
I can live without male Corrin, but I really need female Corrin. And I need both of the Clouds. I don't really need Bayonetta. Headlines. Okay, so we're done with the 3DS section, so now what?
Right. Next up, let's reach a little deeper into our next title, ARMS. Please take a look.
Alright, how long is this arms thing gonna be? Hi there, what on earth? This looks like a character from Nick Jr. I'm sorry. What is this?
I'm usually pretty quiet, but I'm always game to talk about the arms game.
Oh god.
The one with the weaponized extendable arms. So let's get into it. Now stay tuned and always stay in arm's reach.
Okay.
Couldn't resist. Yep, you guessed it. The biggest feature is the weaponry fighters attached to their fists, called arms. There are standard glove-type arms, multi-shot arms that really cause a ruckus, specialized curving arms for cornering opponents, and powerful heavyweight class arms, just to name a few. Each arm has a special attribute that activates when charged
Popper,
up.
Popper, tribalt, fire.
Your opponent to knock him down with fire.
Okay.
Stun and electrify your rival with lightning.
It says electric. With a tornado of it said wind.
And freeze your
it said
ice. Slow him down
okay,
with
I know they're just like...
You get the point.
I don't know, I find it funny.
You want more,
stun,
right?
Blind, perfectly wind, explosion, normal. Ice, electric,
try the
fire.
Arm service, courtesy of the arms league.
Oh, so you have to collect them? Oh, okay, so I guess this is single player?
The in-game currency you earn can be used for a chance to unlock new arms.
Okay, actually this main character doesn't look nearly as stupid as I originally thought. He actually looks kind of cool. His hairstyle is still a meh, but, you know, it is what it is.
There's a veritable treasure trove of arms.
All right, there's quite a few.
Them are pretty tricky themselves.
I think my favorite character design is probably the large guy.
The comeback king of spring.
Maybe the ninja-ish guy.
Who never flinches. The elusive ninja.
Oh, his name's literally Ninja.
And my idol, Ribbon Girl.
Okay, really?
Their unique traits are as distinguished as the fighters themselves. Not to mention, each one can mix and match.
That looks like a cactus. I don't know why it looks like a cactus
That's
to me.
That's right, fighting fans. The game gets deeper and deeper as players discover new combinations of fighters and arms. Now, get a load of this. Today, I'll give you a peek into how deep the strategy can get, and how much it depends on your own approach to arming and using a fighter in an actual match.
Hmm. Okay.
Now, it's time to get amped up, as I introduce to you a new contender, the Ramen Bomber!
Ooh! Okay, I really like her. I like her. I really like her design.
Spicy noodle wielding fighter.
Okay, really?
When she dodges in the air, she can also kick down enemy attacks.
I might actually main this person. I kind of like her design. Yeah, I'm really liking her design.
Wait, you didn't think punches are the only attacks in arms, did you? That's one big
misconception. It's now late. I'm dying.
She can throw
wow.
Opponent,
and isn't this cheating?
Can transform into a dragon.
Well, it's not really a dragon, it's
this
like a robot.
This augmented
okay.
Arm can maintain a longer charge, so beat the sauce out of your rivals. Anyone getting hungry? I wish my arms were made of noodles.
You.
Sorry, I lost myself there for a sec. Next up is the enthusiastic Spring Man. After charging up, release to initiate a shockwave that can repel attacks with his overflowing energy and determination. His famous
okay.
Forte involves deflecting his
opponent's
punches.
Nintendo actually has a lot of fighting games now. I mean, they have Smash, Token, Arms.
When his health drops below
25%, that's three pretty good series that people generally like.
Kicks in, and his punches will stay permacharged. His slick back spring hair isn't just for show.
It isn't.
He actually gets stronger after bouncing back from a desperate situation.
Huh. Oh no, Rage is in the game.
I feel a fight coming. Guess I'll serve as your commentator. Let's see. Min Min has a fiery Ram Ram on the right and a fiery Dragon on the left. She must have a hot temper. Spring Man has a fiery Slap-a-mander on the right and an icy Chilla on the left.
Icy Chilla. Huh. Oh my
sure
god.
Not sure where he's going with that. Well, let's take up.
I don't know why I find how he said that so funny.
Okay, here's Min Min. Right away, she's charging up, and there's her Dragon Arm.
Is this stage like a noodle bowl?
Really
what?
Like a real dragon.
Nah, it's not. It's not deep enough.
The dragon roasts opponents with a high-powered laser. There's a bit of delay before it fires, but its power is exceptional. She's got Springman cornered with her combo attacks, and a left, and a right, and a wait. Springman's counterattack has kicked in after deflecting a shockwave. Her dragon arm has no choice but to return to old ramen noodles.
Hmm.
Both fighters continue to pummel each other. Ouch! He lands a right while dodging the laser. Min-Min won't last if this keeps up. Carefully timing the gaps between punches is an important technique. Wow.
This game actually looks a lot more advanced than I was originally thinking. Like, it looks like it's actually quite deep, which is not something I'd usually say about a motion-based... I mean, I know you can play without motion controls, but still. I'm actually pretty intrigued, not gonna lie. I'm hoping it's like Smash and Pokken, though, where it's easy to learn and hard to master. Well, then again, Pokken's kind of just easy to learn, not that hard to master. But. I mean, it has tech, but like none of it's really that... hard. Oh, there's Super X Factor.
Talk about clarity under pressure.
Okay.
But just how much damage can her right arm take?
Wait, so your arms individually take damage too?
She's completely open to attack until she can. Yes.
Huh,
she
okay.
manages to recover.
Oh, so that's
how
it works.
Smacking down his arms and now a simultaneous punch. Both fighters are desperately trying to recover their footing. Bam! He took that powered-up dragon, and it's not looking good. Springman's last hope is his special comeback. He'll never give up. Min-Min has to finish this match before it's too late. Can she seal the deal?
Is this guy Bulrog?
Yes, she did!
Okay, no rage today.
Min-Min,
I mean, it was kind of obvious she was
going to
win, but... This actually could be as big as Splatoon.
So
might actually...
You? From the fighters to their arms and abilities, there's an arsenal of techniques to unleash, and the rivalry is heating up. Now that is arms. And when I say rivalry, I'm not just talking about one-on-one matches. Sometimes you just gotta shake things up with some two-on-two action. We got a lot more.
Oh, teams. Okay, okay.
So please stay tuned. Stretch the limits of your fighting skills when ARMS launches June 16th.
June 16th. Okay.
Until
okay.
next time, fighting fans.
June 16th. Yeah, okay.
Alongside the launch of ARMS, we'll release a new color of Joy-Con and Joy-Con strap. Neon yellow.
Ooh, yellow.
And we're also releasing a Joy-Con attack.
Can we get like an orange or a dark green one, though? What?
It's nice to have when you want to play for a long time without charging.
Oh.
Next, we'll
wait, a battery attachment? What?
All right.
Ultra Street Fighter. Wait, Minecraft? Okay.
Mario Kart 8 Deluxe marks the return of fan favorite racers and double items.
Yeah.
While introducing a huge
battle. I'm really curious to see how double items is going to affect the game overall.
Plus more characters, carts,
I wonder if we could see Kirby. I mean, I know they already went over the Kirby stuff, but you never know.
The online mode has a fun way of keeping things fresh. Choose race, and you'll join 11 other players and switch between random assortments of tracks. Choose battle, and you'll even switch between modes like good old balloon battle or renegade roundup. So be ready for anything. For a more personalized experience, you can also play with friends in a friend room, where you pick the rules, the items, the CPUs, and more. You can even create or enter a full-fledged in-game tournament. Speaking of, Nintendo will be hosting two of our own, one for racing and one for battle.
Okay.
To celebrate the launch of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
The Mario Kart 8 music is literally phenomenal, though. I never get tired of it. So much saxophone, you know?
Ultra Street Fighter 2, the final challenge, marks 10 years of the beloved classic.
Like, the game itself I don't think is bad, but why is it $40? This should be like 15 to 20. 20 max.
Ultra Street Fighter 2 also features two new playable characters.
New.
The first new additions in the classic roster
wow, that,
in over
what?
20 years. Evil Ryu has succumbed to the murderous Setsui No Hado, and M. Bison has brainwashed his friend, creating Violet Ken. Bringing the
isn't Ken already violent, though?
Fighters. See who reigns supreme.
I'm just saying.
Fierce local or online multiplayer competitions. For a change of pace, the all-new Way of the Hado mode lets you throw out a door.
This will always be fun.
And two-player co-op battles give you and a friend one health bar for two-player versus CPU beatdowns. Want to take it easy? Activate special moves with one button.
No, actually, I don't really care.
Feature. No matter what, take the fight with you on Nintendo Switch.
Still, doing it like that's still better than just adding auto combo to your game. So I mean, whatever.
Minecraft.
Minecraft. Oh, we're getting Samurai Showdown. Okay. I like Samurai Showdown.
explore randomly generated worlds and
build randomly generated
from the simplest homes to the grandest of castles. Play in creative mode with unlimited resources, or mine deep into the world in survival mode, crafting weapons and armor to fend off dangerous mobs. You don't have to explore or build the world alone, though. Up to 8 crafters can play together online, while 4 can join each other in local multiplayer on the TV or in tabletop mode,
okay,
supporting both split-screen and the Nintendo Switch Pro controller. Nintendo and Minecraft fans
Captain
alike
Toad,
to
Wario, Waluigi, I'm assuming,
will be launching on the Nintendo
Mario,
console. Play and explore a world full of
Peach's
classic
Castle
characters and places from the Mario
yeah,
universe.
Yeah, we got it.
Minecraft Nintendo Switch Edition, including the Super Mario Mashup Pack, will launch on Nintendo eShop May 11th.
Huh, I thought that'd just be today, but whatever.
Happy building. Neo Geo masterpieces make awesome.
Okay, what other do we have? I know we have Samurai Showdown. Oh, Fatal Fury, Over Top, never heard of. I have heard of Blazing. Oh, Girl, Mark of Wolves. Yes.
Tomorrow. Look out for these other Golden Age greats coming soon. 99% of the world is dangling in the evil clutches of Eggman and his terrifying new power.
Oh, Sonic Forces. Okay.
But never fear. Sonic is here to face the danger. Now fight back. The world
is this? Is there anything new in this?
Blur, stylish, high-speed moves.
That looks. Is this new?
And who is this alternate version of Sonic, summoned to this world by Eggman?
This looks new.
Can he survive all the traps and return to his home world?
Hmm. Okay. Yeah.
A new ally will rise up as well.
Who? Sonic. Who's the ally?
This is to the West, holiday 2017.
I wanted to know.
There's one more Sonic,
yep, Sonic Mania.
Way. After more than 20 years, a new installment in the classic series' original style is almost here. In addition to brand new stages, some popular
are we gonna get some amiibos? I doubt it.
Sonic Mania will dash onto Nintendo Switch this summer. Project Nakuru is
Project
one big
Nakuru?
Battle of an action game in which players compete by flipping panels. There's only one rule you need to know. Stomp a panel and it'll change to your color.
Huh. That's
Fight to win.
This reminds me of something, but I can't remember what it is. This reminds me of a game though.
Sometimes flipping panels
some,
can yield items.
What? This reminds me of a Mario Party mini game. Which one was it? There is a Mario Party mini game just like this.
Local multiplayer or connect to the internet to face down opponents the world over. Look out for this title exclusively on Nintendo eShop for Nintendo Switch this summer. Fate Extella is headed to Nintendo Switch.
Fate.
An all-star cast of characters from the series.
This is based off the Fate anime, right?
Lead a mythical servant in a fight for dominance against hordes of enemies in this intense action game.
Oh, it's an action game. Okay. I might look into it. I don't know.
Side, you'll crush thousands of enemies all by yourself.
Yeah,
Fate
I don't
Extella
know. Looks pretty decent.
On July
looks
25th.
Decent.
We're about 2 weeks out.
Puyo Puyo Tetris.
Puzzle mashup game, Puyo Puyo Tetris.
This, I know
while
so many people have been waiting for this
with
game.
Tetris, you may be new to Puyo Puyo, a puzzle series that's downright famous in Japan, but hasn't been seen much in the West. Similar to Tetris, pairs of Puyo fall from the top of your board and collect at the bottom. You'll move and rotate the Puyos, but unlike Tetris, your goal isn't to create a line, but to gather a clump of the same color.
Yeah, I think we all know how this
clear
works.
Them from your board. The difference may seem small, but the strategies are very different.
Yeah, anyone
especially
with half a brain probably knows
up
that.
To drop garbage Puyo and sabotage your opponent's board. Are you up for the challenge? Well, a demo is launching on Nintendo eShop shortly after this presentation.
Oh, okay.
Ends.
Good. I mean, you could always download the Japanese demo, but good to have the English
arcade
one.
Arcade and multiplayer arcade modes. Unsure how to play? Well, don't worry. Lessons mode is included as well.
I mean,
well.
What do you mean unsure how to play? It's pretty easy to figure it out, no? I would think.
One of the most famous board games
oh,
ever
Monopoly.
Is coming to Nintendo Switch.
Okay.
Now up to 6 players can enjoy Monopoly in a whole new way and bring the board game to life anywhere at any time. With
okay,
HD
yeah.
Rumble,
that seems like a pretty good
like the dice
choice.
Rolling in your hand. There are exclusive tokens to earn, new boards to discover, and new rules that will change your strategy. Be ready for more additional content, new twists and interactions as you take over the whole board when
you know
the
I'm
going to
be buying that Gore Mark of Wolves like as soon as that's out there.
Rayman Legends.
Rayman Legends. I'm pretty sure we knew about this, but okay. Game.
Pick your favorite character.
Wait, what? Did that say Splatoon Doc? Again
into the mythical glade of dreams.
Did that say
the
Splatoon Doc?
Run, jump, and smack their way through different worlds.
Am I crazy?
The day and discover the secrets of each legendary painting. Exclusive.
I might be crazy because I thought that said Splatoon Doc.
The Kung Fu Experience now offers a solo mode and a tournament mode for pitting up to 8 teams against each other. You can also
okay,
connect
no, no, no,
two
I,
consoles for playing in local co-op. Get ready for a lot of laughs when the game launches later this year. If you're game for something different, then THQ Nordic has your back.
Hmm?
The Dieselbug shoot 'em up game Cinemora X was co-developed by Grasshopper Manufacturer and Digital Reality.
Okay.
Find out what choices you'd make if you knew exactly how much life you had left to live when the stirring tale of honor and morality launches on Nintendo Switch this summer.
Sure.
Complete with a local co-op and versus mode.
Okay, sure.
Battle Chasers Night War.
This looks interesting.
RPG inspired by console
classics. What is this? Is this
and based on the fan favorite Battle Chasers comic book series. You can dive deep into its
interesting,
dungeons.
Interesting.
And even deeper into its turn-based combat.
Okay,
when the game
it's an RPG,
releases
I'm
first
assuming.
On Nintendo Switch in late summer.
That's pretty good character designs. Available summer.
Getting paid to be the bad guy.
Payday 2. Are you kidding me? They actually got Payday 2.
You and three other players can band together for intense co-op.
I'm actually surprised. They,
rise to the top of
I'm actually surprised they got
paid. Better jobs and better paydays. Use the cash you stash.
I don't know. Wow.
New skills that change the way you play.
I'm actually surprised.
A huge amount of Payday 2 content will be released on Nintendo Switch. So it'll be high time to open this vault later this year.
I don't know why I find that so funny.
Some of the most Namco games of all time are headed to Nintendo Switch. With Namco Museum, you can play classics like Pac-Man, Galaga, or Splatterhouse anytime. All right,
I can get behind this one. And oh, I think I had this. Like wasn't Rolling this a PSP Thunder, game? This was a PSP game, I'm telling you.
Co-op with family and friends.
I still loved it, though, so I don't mind it.
Horizontal display, or even switch to a vertical layout for that classic arcade feel. Stop and resume your gameplay at any time with ease while testing your skills in fun challenges.
Oh, it has a challenge mode this time, though. Okay.
The classic fun begins.
So, I feel like there should be one. They didn't even talk about Splatoon yet, have they?
We're happy to confirm that
wait, what? Wii U.
Of the standalone Nintendo Switch dock will be available for purchase May 19th. You can hook up an extra dock to a separate TV, so you can switch from one to the other without...
Oh, I never thought about doing that. That actually might be kind of useful.
It's available at participating retailers or head to store.nintendo.com. Grab three of your best Inkling teammates and fire up your Wii U console, because BattleFi is hosting the Splatoon US Inkling Open, the online event you've been waiting for. You're 18 years or older and based in the US. You can register your team at battlefy.com/splatoon, where you'll also find details, rules, and tournament times. Who knows? If you splat with the best of them, you may even win a trip to E3 2017.
Is that it? Are we done?
Well, let's dive into our last game of the day.
Splatoon
2.
Yep. The last game until they show a Smash trailer, right? Huh? What? What is this? What? What is this? What? Come join our ranks. Okay. What on earth? What are they like? What? So are we no longer like fighting the Octolings? Is that not? This reminds me of Fallout, like the Fallout trailers and stuff.
Are your regulatory
research
systems
report?
Functioning? On behalf of the Squid Research Lab, I certainly hope so, because the findings we're about to present may be startling. Oh, that's right. You may be wondering about the Squid Research Lab. Well, we research squids in a lab. And other things, too, like that strange video. Perhaps what you saw seemed a bit unusual, but research indicates that freelance power egg collection is becoming quite popular among Inklings in a new mode called Salmon Run. Luckily, one of our fearless researchers went on.
They remind me of the Dust Crew. Or the crew. What was the name? It was called like Dust Force. That game. This is what this artwork reminds me of.
For the first time on film, we can see this remote location, separated from Inkopolis, on the other side of the ocean.
Sure.
This derelict man-made island is a
hot. So there are humans here? Like, how does this work?
Amazing. Inkling super jumping to the island.
Okay.
We concluded that four Inklings make a team, just like in Turf War. What are they wearing? The implications. It looks like some kind of special gear provided just for this task. Huh. And it appears they're given weaponry, too.
Sure.
It's a power egg collector's job to defeat creatures of the salmonid genus who habitually attack for some unknown reason.
Chum.
And it's not just
we're SpongeBob now. We have the green and orange. This is Nickelodeon.
As you can see,
they're about to announce the television show.
Salmon.
Power egg.
It may sound easy.
Okay.
What's this?
Some
sort of salmonid. To tell the truth, it's unlike anything we've ever seen.
Oh, it has tires, I think.
Ooh, that's it. It's a special kind of boss.
Where? I don't see any steel.
Paid a bounty to hunt. I'm afraid our brave
so this is like PvE, no I guess, right?
At least, not
makes sense.
Oh, one of the Inklings is down.
Yeah, this is PvE.
And another. Yet somehow, the incapacitated Inkling has deployed a lifesaver to call for help. Oh, I see. When a fallen freelancer gets inked by an ally, that Inkling can be resuscitated. Freelancing does have its benefits. Communication is key because Inklings that work together win together.
Sure.
Unless they don't. What an honor it is to witness this incredible struggle. How odd. These eggs have a rare appearance, even among power eggs.
Golden eggs.
Could they be golden eggs?
Sure.
And now it looks with, like the Inklings are transporting these golden eggs
from Sonic.
To a containment unit in the center of the site. Aha! Could it be that this is the freelancer's ultimate objective?
Maybe.
To harvest these golden eggs and haul them to Inkopolis?
Sure.
Indeed, after many trials and tribulations, the Inklings have collected their golden egg prize and fulfilled their corporate agenda.
I suppose.
What we witnessed here is the harsh reality of one suspicious part-time job. Why would such a dismal occupation be so popular among Inklings?
I don't know.
Well, it might be due to the rewards.
Ooh,
I've heard they're quite
the PVE
fresh.
Rewards.
Is it? More research may be required.
A bowling ball is your reward?
What a day for science. If we compile any new information, you will be the first to know. We're planning to release a research report on the ongoing battle with Octarians, so stay tuned and stay fresh.
Sure.
That reminds me, we have one last report for you. It's a scientific
amiibo.
Two series amiibo will be released. There are three new figures. Inkling Girl, Inkling Boy, and Inkling Squid.
Okay. I like them.
When you tap these amiibo, the figure character will appear in-game and befriend you.
Is this still like the same thing as the original game or what?
Befriend an amiibo character and they'll remember your favorite outfits, weapons, gear, and option sets.
Sure.
Tap your amiibo on the customization menu screen and you can swap your outfit with the amiibo figure's outfit. I'd imagine it comes in handy when waging turf wars at a friend's house.
Wait, so what is this?
To conduct your own research, try snapping a photo with your amiibo friend. That way you can both wear your favorite outfits.
Eh.
Then you can share your photos with human friends on social media via the Nintendo
oh my
Switch
goodness.
Album.
Okay, the amiibo use is kind of lame, but I mean, it's whatever.
Here is a gift.
Oh no, here. That one looks so stupid. That one looks kind of cool.
The game is compatible with previously released Splatoon amiibo figures as well. Well, fellow researchers, today's presentation is over. We look forward to sharing more research in the future. Thanks for... Oh, forgive my apparent short-term memory loss. I have one last fact for you. Splatoon 2 launches July 21st.
Okay.
And the new amiibo release that same day.
Sure.
That's all for today's report. Squid Research Lab, signing off.
I hope you enjoyed this new Nintendo Direct. Thanks for watching.
All right, I guess that's it. That was all right.